Hey everyone, it's Mr. Fleece here, and in this video I want to teach you how to build your palette mixing tints and shades of temper paint to create a monochromatic piece. Check out all of my tints and shades of blue. I want to teach you how you can create your own palette just like this. Okay, so I'm going to show you how I build a monochromatic palette using temper paint. Here's an example right here, starting with the lightest blue, working our way around to the darkest shade. So the first thing I'm going to do is pick a starting point, and I tend to start with my light colors first. So I'm going to pour out a little bit of white. Once I have my whites poured, I'm going to start with one drop of blue. One, two, three drops of blue. One, two, three, four drops of blue. And that's going to start my tinting process. I give this a little stir. And now I've got a lovely tint of blue, but that's still pretty blue. Notice how this matches closer to this value here. So how did I get this value, this value, and this value? Well, to get those lighter values, I'm going to take a little bit of white, and I'm going to grab a small amount of the lightest blue that I just made with my drop of blue, and I'm going to stir that into a white. This is going to give me a really, 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 really bright tint of blue. Then I can towel off that color, and I'm going to grab some more of this, and I'm going to actually put two drops in the next one. So I can make this one just a little bit darker than the first one. Very nice. And then I'm gonna do the same thing, except for now I'm gonna put one, two, three scoops in this one so that my blues progressively get a touch darker as I work my way to my tint. I'm gonna put one more little one in there. There we go. So now I've got a variety of light blues right through here. Very nice sky blues, good for bright values. Now I'm gonna stir together my next tint. Goal here is that this tint is just slightly darker than this one. So if it doesn't show up that way, put maybe one more little drop of blue. Notice how I use tiny drops of blue. Blue is going to change that color drastically. So I use small amounts, and that's pretty nice. Now I can go ahead and mix this one that I put the most blue in, and I can add another drop of blue in here as well. Starting to get a nice darker blue. Now I can continue to mix more tints and getting them darker and darker by just adjusting the ratio of white to blue, and you can get a variety of more tints. So I want a few light, a few mediums, and a couple of dark blues. That's nice. There we go. Now I've got a variety of tints happening. Let's mix a couple of shades. So to mix your shades, you're gonna start with regular blue in the palette. And then the first one, I'm gonna put a couple drops of black. And this one, I'm gonna put a little bit more, almost like a 50-50. So here I'm gonna stir this together to get a dark blue. My first shade of blue. And that's really nice, it's like a navy. And then this blue, I want it to be so dark that when you look at it, it almost appears black, right? Like this is gonna be the darkest blue on my monochromatic piece. And there you have it. So that right there is how you can mix a lovely range of monochromatic colors using temper paint. I recommend using 5 to 10 tints and shades of a color in a monochromatic piece, so that way you have enough variety to make the piece look interesting. I've got 9 different shades right here, and they are all ready to go to the paper. All right, so in this palette, you're seeing all of the tints and shades of blues I've used in this piece here. This dark value is here. This next dark value is what I used here in the sky. Then this value is what I used for the first set of the hills. Then I used this value in the second set of hills. Then I used this value in the third set of hills. This is the value I used right on the horizon line. Then I've used this for my clouds here, here, little cloud there, and then I use this light tint to show the sky in between those clouds right in through here. And that is how I utilized these blue tints and shades to create a final monochromatic landscape. All right, everybody, thanks for watching this video on how I mix tints and shades of temper paint to create a monochromatic palette. You can use these tints and shades to create all types of artwork. I use this monochromatic palette to paint this landscape of mountains right here. So I hope that you enjoyed that mixing tutorial. Look forward to seeing what you create. Take care, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.